Hello guys, welcome to my second class of Inverse Laplace Transform. In my first class, we discussed how we get inverse Laplace Transform formula from Laplace Transform. Now we are going to take some problems how to solve by using inverse Laplace Transform. Now already I told, if you want to obtain inverse, always are expecting a function in terms of parameter. Then suppose find the Laplace transform of the following functions. Instead of writing in each and every problem, I am going to write one of the statements here. Find the inverse Laplace transform of the following functions. The first function is S1 divided by S into S plus 1. Now 1 divided by S into S plus 1, I have to find out L inverse of this. Have so many methods. Now you please try to understand. Now I want to find out L inverse of what actually solution is nothing but 1 by S into S plus 1. Now suppose you multiply by S, what we get actually S square plus S. Now here we don't have any constant term. It's a quadratic form, but the constant term is because suppose you multiply S into S plus 1, what we get actually S square plus S. Which term is missing? Constant term is missing. There are so many methods to proceed. Either you go for completing the square method or by using partial fraction to proceed. But you can't find out directly because we don't have any standard formula for L inverse of 1 by S into S plus 1. Therefore, now either you go for completing the square method or you go for partial fraction. Now here, I am not going to use completing the square method because I don't have any constant term here. After you multiply S into S plus 1. Now what I am going to do here, now better instead of complete the square method, I am going to use partial fraction. Now while taking, now first I have considered this fraction separately and try to convert in the form of sum of the two terms by using partial fraction. You already know that the condition of the partial fraction, if you want to go for partial fraction, the fraction must be proper. Yeah, this is a proper because what's the highest degree of the numerator of S is 0. Highest degree of the denominator is S into S is S square 2. Degree of the numerator is less than degree of the denominator, then we say this partial, then we say that it's a proper fraction. Otherwise, an improper means degree of the numerator is greater than or equal to degree of the denominator. Now we treat it as an improper. But AA is a proper. Now I am going to apply partial fraction. While applying a partial fraction, observe carefully in the denominator. I think is everyone clear, you can't apply partial fraction directly. First, I have to verify is it proper or improper. Is it proper, then I will proceed. Now, first observe the denominator, both the factors are linear because the power of S is 1. Next, and also non-repeated because S plus 1, the power is 1, S power is 1. Therefore, it is a non-repeated linear factors. From the partial fraction, this can be written as A by S, B by S plus 1. Because both are non-repeated linear factors. After applying the partial fraction with depletion, you take LCM. What's LCM in the right hand side? S into S plus 1. Now what do we get? A into S plus 1 plus B into S. What's the left hand side here? 1 by S into S plus 1. Now I have to cancel both denominators. What's the remaining now? 1 equals S plus 1 into A plus S into B. I have to give a different values of S to find out A and B. Suppose you put S is equal to minus 1, what happens? A is 0, B is we get. That implies 1 equals, this is 0 because minus 1 plus 1 is 0, A is 0, then minus 1 into B. That implies what is my B value? Minus 1. Similarly, I have to put S is equal to 0. Just you put 0, what we get? B 0, A is retained. That implies 1 equals A. Therefore, immediately we get A and B value. Therefore, L inverse of 1 by S into S plus 1 is nothing but, I am going to write the two terms here, inverse of, what is the A value? 1 by S. What is B value? Minus 1 by S plus 1. Now, why I have to use the partial fraction here? Because we don't have any standard formula for A inverse of this. Therefore, I am trying to convert in the standard form. From the linear property, what's the linear property you know for Laplace? Same linear property I have to apply. L inverse of the first function minus L inverse of the second function. How we get? From the linear property. Linear property. Okay. The next, we discussed in the previous class, these two are in the standard form. Now we know that what is L inverse of 1 by S is nothing but 1. And also, L inverse of 1 by S minus A, we know that what is actually e power at. That implies L inverse of 1 by S into S plus 1 is nothing but L inverse of 1 by S is 1 minus, instead of S minus A what you have S plus 1, therefore S plus 1 can be written as S minus of minus 1. Therefore, what is my A value? Minus 1. Therefore, e power of minus t. This is nothing but L inverse of the function is what actually 1 by s plus 1. 1 by s into s plus 1. Now, what I did? Either you go for complete square method or you go for partial. I feel going for partial fraction is very simple. Therefore, I have to convert into sum of two terms and then apply Laplace transform of 1 by s and 1 by s plus 1, because these two standard formula we already know that. This is a way to find out inverse transform of the given function. Now I am moving to the second problem. This is a different problem. The problem is s plus 1 divided by s square plus 6x plus 9. I want to find out inverse. Therefore solution is L inverse of S plus 1 divided by S square plus 6x plus 9. Now observe, in the denominator is a quadratic form. They have a S square term, they have a linear term, they have a constant term. Therefore I go for complete the square method. Now you already know that we already studied the basic thing, what's the meaning of complete the square method. We try to convert that the sum of these terms is nothing but either in the form of a plus b whole square or maybe in the form of a minus b whole square. After by using the add and subtract the value, that is called completing the square method. Now where I am going to use complete the square method? Whenever the denominator values are in the form of polynomial, especially for quadratic form. Now this can be written as a square. All three terms are positive. Therefore, what's my preference? I have to convert which one? A plus b whole square. Suppose a square, here having minus sign, I go for which one? A minus b whole square. Please try to understand this. My a is s, a square plus 2ab. I split 6 into 2 and I want, what's the remaining? 3 into s. My A is S, 2A, what's the remaining is 3. 3 is my B. Therefore, I required what actually? What do you need actually? 3 means 3 square. Are you clear? But already 9 is nothing but what actually? 3 square. Therefore, this is nothing but what? S plus 3 whole square. Therefore, S square plus 6X plus 9 can be written as S plus 3 whole square. Therefore, this is nothing but L inverse of S plus 1 divided by S plus 3 whole square. Yes? Now, you recall what about that shifting property for L inverse of S is there means cos only. What about that S minus B divided by S minus B whole square. What about that actually? Now, the thing is what actually S minus B whole square plus whatever that A square is nothing but e power of at. Are you clear? I think it's clear everyone. And then, what's another one thing is e power of at into e power of bt into what actually? Cos at. But here, which one is missing? Constant term is missing. Therefore, what we are going to use, L inverse of e power of a t into t power of n is nothing but, yeah, what about that? N factorial divided by s minus a to the power of n, n plus 1. Yes, I go for which one? This formula only, L inverse of, L inverse of 1 by s minus a to the power of n plus 1 is nothing but e power of a t into t power of n divided by n factorial. This formula we are going to use. Therefore, why? Because here which one is missing? Constant term. But numerator have s plus 1, but denominator having s plus 3. I don't want s. Suppose I go for this formula. Are you clear or not? Therefore, what I am going to do here, I require instead of s plus 1, what you require s plus 3. Suppose I write s plus 3, how much you have taken 2. Therefore, this can be written as L inverse of s plus 3, I'll group it one term, minus 2. 3 minus 2, we get 1 only, divided by s plus 3 whole square. Why I did like that? I'm going to split. S plus 3 divided by s plus 3 whole square is cancelled. What we get actually? 1 by s plus 3. And then we get minus 2 by s plus 3 whole square. Then easy to proceed. Because of that, what I did? I tried to convert numerator also in terms of the denominator. Why I did like that? Because I go for this formula. Why I have to use this formula? Here which one is missing? Constant term is missing. Therefore, now from the linear property, this can be written as s plus 3 divided by, I think everyone is clear why I have to convert in the form of s plus 3, because denominator having s plus 3. What factor you have in the denominator, based on that you convert in the numerator. Minus 2 into L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 whole square. Now, it's cancelled from which property? Linear property. Now, L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 and then minus 2 into L inverse of what? 1 by s plus 3 whole square. Now, we have a standard formula. Based on that, we know that L inverse of 1 by whatever that is minus a is nothing but e power of a t, and then L inverse of, or written the board, 1 by s minus a to the power of n plus 1, what we get actually, e power of a t into t power of n by n factorial. Therefore, from this, L inverse 1 by, instead of a, what you have minus a, because s plus 3 can be written as, it's already I explained, s minus of minus a. What is minus of minus is plus, what is my a? Minus 3 e power of minus 3 t. Minus 2 into L inverse of this. Now I'll go for this formula. What is my a value? Minus 3 e power of minus 3. And also here what you have? L inverse of 1 by a square. Are you clear now? L inverse of, if you want to apply shifting property, take the 3 outside. Are you clear from this formula? L inverse of 1 by s square. Or if you want to directly from this formula, what's the value now? E power of minus 3t. S square can be written as 1 plus 1. The n value is 1. Now from the original formula, we get same thing. 2 into e power of minus 3t. What is that actually? S value 1. Yes, sorry, n value 1. What we get? T power of 1 divided by 1 factorial. What's 1 factorial value is 1. Therefore, finally we get, what we get actually, e power of minus 3t minus 2t into what? E power of minus 3t. Because 1 factorial value is 1. This is a way to find out that my L inverse. You please try to understand. I'm going to explain it in 1 minute how to proceed this. Now, in the numerator having s, denominator having a quadratic form, better I have to go for complete the square method. Instead of to apply, we don't have any product of more than one function, no need I have to go for partial fraction method. I'm trying to convert by using complete the square method. we get all the terms are positive, what's the possibility a plus b whole square. After you convert, now you can't go for this formula, I go for this, I don't want s. Therefore, I'm trying to convert s in terms of s plus 3, then I'm going to cancel it. Therefore, add and subtract by 2, we get s plus 3 minus 2. From the linear property, I take the inverse of first term minus inverse of the second term. Now, after this year, what we get actually, when factors are cancelled, what's the remaining is 1 by s plus 3. Another one is to take the inverse of 1 by s plus 3 whole square. If you want to apply directly this formula, all you are going to apply shifting property. I explained in my previous class what's a shifting property. Now, from this formula, what we get actually, e power of my a is minus of minus 3, e power of minus 3 t. First you apply the shifting property, take it as a outside, e power of a t. What is a is minus 3, l inverse of the remaining, other than 3. What is other than 3 is 1 by square. Now, from the Laplace of t power of a, what do we get? A square can be written as 1 plus 1, therefore t power of 1 by 1 factorial. This is a way to find out inverse of the function by using complete the square method. And I think you are clear how to solve. I solve one problem by using partial fraction. I solve one problem by using complete the square method. I am going to take some more problems in next part of my further video. Thank you very much for listening my talk.